Alright, in this video we're going to talk about long division of polynomials. And long division of polynomials is a lot like normal long division, except, well, now you're doing things with variables. The first thing you want to do for long division of polynomials is basically rewrite it so that the stuff on the top goes underneath the bar, and whatever you're dividing by goes out front. And a couple things I want to point out. Notice that the powers are in descending order. It goes from the second power to the first power to just a number, and likewise, the thing you're dividing by, it goes in descending powers. We have our first power and then just a number. If things aren't written this way, that's the very first thing you'll want to do, is put them in this order. Most problems give them to you in descending order, but in case somebody's just trying to confuse you, be aware of that. So all you really do is you focus in on the first thing out front here, the x, and you focus in on the first thing underneath, and I think, well, x times what is going to give me x squared? Well, x times x gives me x squared, and then what I do is I multiply, so x times x is x squared, x times negative 2 is negative 2x, and then I put this stuff in parentheses and I subtract it away. So I subtract, so x squared minus x squared is no x squareds, and that's what always should happen. Your first thing should cancel out. You'll get 4x minus negative 2x, which is 4x plus 2x, or 6x, and then we'll drop down our negative 8. And now I do the same thing as before. I'm still thinking about the x, but now I'm focusing in on the 6x. Once the first term that you get after you do your subtraction has lesser degree than the thing out front, you'll stop. So right now, x and x are the same degree, so I'm going to do this long division, or excuse me, this multiplication again. So I think x times what is 6x, and I would need a positive 6. So positive 6 times x is 6x. 6 times negative 2 is negative 12. Again, I put this in parentheses and subtract it. So I'll get 6x minus 6x, which is no x. I'll get negative 8 minus negative 12. So that's negative 8 plus 12. Negative 8 plus 12 is simply 4. So what this says is, in conclusion, so this is what we started with, x squared plus 4x minus 8 over x minus 2, it says that we can actually rewrite that as the stuff on top, x plus 6, and then the 4 out here at the bottom is considered our remainder, so we'll write 4 over what we were originally dividing by. So this would be your final solution in terms of rewriting things. Okay, so the stuff on top is what goes out front, your remainder goes on top of the fraction, and what you're dividing by goes on the bottom of the fraction. Okay, so let's do maybe one more of these. So in this problem, okay, same thing. Notice I've got things in descending powers, x cubed, x to the first, 6, and then x squared and z and a plus 1. But notice in the top part there's no x squared term. And in the bottom part there's no x terms. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill that in as a placeholder. So let me give myself a little more room down here. So I've got x cubed plus 0 x squared plus 4x plus 6, and I'm dividing this by x squared plus 0 x's plus 1, and now I just do the same thing as before. I look at my first term and my first term, and I think x squared times what is x cubed? Well, I would need an x to the first, and then I simply multiply everything out front. X times x is x cubed, x times 0x is going to give me, well, 0x squared, x times 1 is going to give me positive x, I subtract things away, and in this case I'll get 4x minus x, which is 3x, and then I'll simply drop my plus 6 down. But now we're already done. There's no more long division to do, because if you look at the first term of what I get after I do my subtraction, I get an x to the first term, but x squared has a larger degree than x to the first, so once that happens, once the first term out front has a higher degree than what you get after you do the subtraction, you stop. Okay, so it says basically we can write x cubed plus 4x plus 6 over x squared plus 1. It says we can write that as x, and our remainder, 3x plus 6 over x squared plus 1. And our long division would be complete. Okay? So maybe let me do one more, because I've got time here, so I'll just make up one more off the top of my head. Suppose we have x to the third plus 2x squared plus x plus 1. And we're dividing this all by just, again, maybe a linear term, x minus 3. So notice now none of the terms are missing, so I don't have to fill any of these sort of placeholders in. So I've got x to the third plus 2x squared plus x plus 1, and then outside I'll put my x minus 3. So again, I think x times what is x to the third? And that'll be x squared. So if I multiply x squared times x is x to the third, x squared times negative 3 is negative 3x squared. Put this in parentheses and subtract. So the x cubes will cancel out. I'll have a 2x squared plus a 3x squared, which is 5x squared. And I'll drop down my plus x term. And now I think x times what is 5x squared. Well, I would need a positive 5x to get that. Positive 5x times x is 5x squared. 5x times negative 3 is negative 15x. So again, I do my subtraction. My 5x squareds will cancel out. I'll get x plus 15x, which is 16x. And now I drop down my positive 1. We keep going because the thing I'm dividing by, the x, has the same degree as my 16x. So I think x times what is 16x? Well, in that case, I would need a positive 16. So I'll get positive 16x. 16 times negative 3 is negative 48. Again, I put this in parentheses and subtract. The 16x's will cancel out. I'll get positive 1 plus 48, which will give me positive 49. My 49 is just a number that has smaller degree than x, so I'm done. This is going to be my remainder. And again, what it says is, the original thing we were dividing, it said x cubed plus 2x squared plus x plus 1. Over x minus 3, it says you can rewrite this as the stuff on top, x squared plus 5x plus 16, and then we just put our remainder, 49, over what we were originally dividing by, which was the x minus 3. And that will be your answer after you've done long division. So long division is one of these things. It's a little tedious, but if you forget how to do regular long division with just numbers, I would encourage you to look at that, because you're using the same process. So if you've forgotten how to do long division with numbers, you may want to review that. I think it'll make this stuff make some more sense. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email. I've got tons of videos on my website as well, dealing with a lot of other algebra topics too, so feel free to take a look, and hopefully this helps. And like I said, if you have any questions, just send me an email and I'll be happy to answer them.